So very good morning to all my dear students. Yes. So we are with chapter 4, recording of transactions 2. Yes. What are we learning in this chapter? Yes, please tell me.
Cash books, purchase book.
Yes, cash book, purchase book, purchase return,
and sales return.
Sales return. What are all these together called?
Cash, journal.
Journal? They are all journals. Subsidiary books. That means the journal is divided into various books. It is journal only, but based on the similarities, the characteristics, they are classified according to their similarity into different books. That is the subsidiary books. Okay, tell me about cash book now.
Only cash transactions.
All the cash transactions are recorded in the cash book. Then, if you are preparing a cash book, is it required to prepare a ledger, cash account? We are maintaining, the business is maintaining a cash book. Then, is it required to prepare a cash account? Yes or no? Not required. Cash book serves the duty of both journal as well as ledger. If you are maintaining a cash book, a separate book for cash transactions, then it is not required to prepare the cash account. Okay? Coming to talking about the two sides of cash book. What are they? Debit side and credit side. What kind of transactions are recorded on the debit side?
Cash received.
Okay. And what about the credit side?
Cash spent.
It is the cash payments. Okay. Now, tell me the different types of cash book. Single column cash book, double column cash book, then triple column cash book. Okay, why is this names single column, double column, triple column? What is the differences? Yes, Alan, tell me. Alan Shibu, are you there? Are you facing network issue? Pavitra, can you tell me? Why is this names? What is the difference? Single column cash book, double column cash book, triple column cash book. What is the differences between all these cash books? Where is the difference? In the single column cash book, there is only one amount column. All the amounts are written there only. In the double column cash book, we provide two amount columns. One for cash, other for bank. And the third one, triple column cash book, we have three amount column, each on the debit side as well as the credit side. Okay? This is the difference. This is what it makes the difference between the cash books. Okay, that is about cash book. Next book we learnt is the purchase book. What kind of transactions are recorded in the purchase book? Yes? Credit purchases only. Credit transaction related to purchase. So what about cash purchase? Where do you record the cash purchase of goods? Yes? Cash purchase. Where do you record it? Yes, Pranav?
purchase return.
The cash purchase. Cash purchase of book goods. Where do you record it?
Cash book.
It is in the cash book. Then what for are you maintaining a cash book? It is in the cash book we all record all the cash transactions. So cash purchase means it will be recorded in the cash book. Only the credit purchase we are recording in the purchase book. Same with the case of sales book. Only credit sales come inside the sales book. Cash sales, it is in the cash book. Okay? So this was a quick revision on this chapter, recording of transactions 2. And today we are going to see the preparation of purchase returns book. What is it? Purchase returns book. Okay, open the textbook, take the page, purchase returns. So let us see how to prepare purchase returns book. Coming to what is purchase return, let me ask that first. When you purchase something, if it is not according to your expectation, you received goods of poor quality or there are damaged goods, then what we do? We will return the goods back to the shopkeeper. Am I right? That is called purchase return. Whatever goods are purchased, we are returning it back. Okay, that is purchase return. Tell me, what is the transaction, what is the journal entry for cash purchase? Quick. What is the transaction journal entry for cash purchase? Purchase account debtor to cash. Okay, so what will be the journal entry if it is returned? Purchase returns. Purchase is always Can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Purchase is always purchase account debit to cash. Right? So we are returning it back. Then what happens? When you return back, you get the money back. They will refund you, no? So what is the journal entry? Cash account debit to purchase return. To purchase return, we will just reverse this first entry. Here, purchase account debtor to cash. When it is returned, then the entry becomes cash account debtor to purchase return. Okay, this is regarding the cash transaction. Now, how about a credit transaction? Purchase account debtor to the supplier. Yes, to the supplier. So, what will be the entry when it is returned back? Supplier account debtor to purchase return. Clear, no? Purchase return. Now, let's see the preparation, how to prepare it. You can see purchase return book, date, and here in the case of purchase return, similarly we have sales return also. Okay, the sold goods is returned back. There is a document prepared called debit note. Debit note. Debit note is a document prepared asking the supplier to refund back the money. Okay? So regarding the purchase return, a document prepared. That is called debit note. And coming to the sales return. If it is a sales return, that means the sold goods, the business make the sales, the customer purchases it, and the sold goods is returned back to the business. Then it becomes sales return. Sales return, then the document prepared is credit note. So instead of the invoice number, usually what is the column head that we give here? It is the invoice number. So instead of invoice number, we have to give the name debit note number. Then everything is the same. Name of the supplier, LF, amount. Okay. Let us see an example in the textbook. Then I will give you a problem. Debit note and credit note. There is an example in the textbook. Let us discuss that. Okay. So earlier we had the purchase book. We did the problem purchase book. Now, referring to that question, they say that there was a supplier Kanika Traders. Okay? Kanika Traders we had purchased 20 TV, 15 tape recorders from Nima Electronics. We had done this problem from the textbook. The illustration problem, purchase book from the textbook, we had written it in detail. Yes? Nima Electronics. Yes. So we are referring to that question here. See, it says that we had purchased 20 mini TV and 15 tape recorders from Nima Electronics, and that is returned. That is returned. So what happens? We will write the name Nima Electronics, debit note is given, and usual way we will calculate and write the amount. Okay? The procedure is clear? Whatever is purchased, the same way, the calculation what we did earlier for purchase book and sales book. 20 TV into the amount, 15 TV into whatever it is, into the amount. That way we will calculate and write the amount there. Same procedure. We will find out the total of the amount column. That's it. So, shall I give you a question? Yes. Let us do a question. It is not in the textbook. I'll be giving a separate question. Please take down the question. Enter the following transactions. Enter the following transactions in the purchase return book. In the purchase return book, of Hari, who is dealing in automobiles. So it is clearly given what is the business he is dealing with. It is the automobiles. So if anything else you find other than automobiles, we should not take it. If suppose it is given, returned 10 kg rice back to the grocery. Is it required to be written in this book? No. We just have to consider the transactions related to automobiles only. Okay. And post them into ledger. Ledger. Okay. 2017. January 5th. Return to
Ma'am, are you screen sharing?
Yes. You can see? All of you? None of you can see? No? Let me share it again. Just a second. Can you see now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Return to Anand. Anand. 5 clutch plates. 5 clutch plates. At rupees 200 each. Not in accordance with order. That means it is not according to the order, not per the order. So that is returned. Next one, January 14. Take down the question. Returned to Chandran 4 brake shoes at ₹200 each and 10 rear view mirrors at ₹350 each due to inferior quality. Due to poor quality, the business has returned it. That's it. I hope the question is clear. Enter the following transactions in the purchase return book of Hari, who is dealing in automobiles, and post them into ledger. 2017, Jan 5, return to Anand, 5 clutch plates at ₹200 each, not in accordance with order. It was not in the order, so we returned it. Jan 14, return to Chandran, 4 brake shoes, at ₹200 each and 10 rear view mirrors at ₹350 each due to inferior quality. Okay, now question is clear.
In this, what is the debit number?
If it is not in the question, you may leave the column blank, no problem. Only thing is, you should give that column head. And you may put nil or give a small slash. So draw in the books of Hari, the heading, in the books of Hari, purchase returns book. Yes. Do it and tell me the answer. Vishnu is absent. Alan Vergi is absent. Vishnu, Alan, then who else? Aman is here, Anish, Alan Thomas. Alan is here. Alan Vergi, you are there. Yes, Alan is here. Then Krishna, Pavitra, Rose, Aparna. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, Alan. I was checking who is absent. Naveen Jobi is absent. Vishnu. Correct, no? Yes.
And we should write that why we are returning it.
Sorry?
We should write that not according with order also.
Yes. Always we'll date, no? You're talking about the date?
No.
That?
Not in accordance with order.
That is not required. That is the reason why we have returned it. That's all.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. First prepare the purchase return book, tell me the final amount, then prepare the ledger. Ledger, how many ledgers are required? Two ledgers, three ledgers. Purchase returns account, Anand account, Chandran account. Yes, correct answer. Who was that? Sayuja, right answer. Aparna, right answer. So please prepare the ledger accounts now. Akshay, right answer. Rose, right answer. Yes, Rahul, Krishnuni. Who is this one? Pranav, check your answer, please. Calculation mistake. Do it carefully. Those who have completed, start doing the problem number 15. 15, prepare a purchase return book from the following transaction. Okay. Question number 15 in the numerical session. Anish, right answer. Question number 15 in the textbook. Prepare the ledger accounts, okay? Only after preparing ledger accounts you will do the next question. Yes, Pranav, right answer. So please be careful with your calculations. The preparation of all these books are very simple. As I say, it is all simple mathematic calculations, multiplication, addition. So please be careful. Don't lose your marks. Completed the ledger accounts? Only after completing the ledger accounts you will go for the next question. How many of you completed ledger accounts? Raise your hand. Give me the sticker. Raise your hand in Zoom. No, Krishna. It is not that amount. You gave the right answer, no? Was it Krishna Unil? I saw one Krishna. It was Krishna Unil, not Krishna Gandhi. Okay. It is not the amount. The total is 5,300. 5,300. Pavitra, did you get the answer? Wait. Tell me the answer. Respond, then you mute. I didn't hear anything. Don't be in a hurry to mute. Yes, Pavitra, tell me. Did you get the answer? Yes, right. Okay, good. Krishna, check your answer. Where is the calculation mistake? So prepare the ledger accounts. After preparing the ledger account, raise your hands. Then only you will move to the question number 15. Yes, Rahul. Good. Rahul, tell me, where is the amount written in the purchase returns account? Is it on the debit or credit?
No, credit.
Sorry?
Credit.
Okay. Good. Right. Yes, Krishna. Good. Do the ledger, raise your hand. Once you complete, raise your hand. Yes, who is that one? Akshay, tell me the amount in Anand account. Where did you write the amount?
In the credit side, 1,000 rupees.
Credit side? Is it in the credit side? What is the journal entry? Just a second, let me take the board. Okay. Anand account. And first of all, the journal entry is Anand account debtor to purchase returns. Right? This is the journal entry. Anand account debtor to purchase returns. We are preparing Anand account. So Anand account, what is it being done? Anand account is debited. So come to the debit side, write to purchase returns. Okay, to purchase returns, and the amount is 1000. Is it clear? Same with the case of, what is the next person? Chandran account. Again, the journal entry will be Chandran account debtor to purchase returns. Chandran account debtor. So Chandran account is also debited. So in the Chandran account, come to the debit side, write purchase returns, and the amount, how much is it? 4300. Is it clear to everyone? And when you prepare the purchase returns account, let me prepare the purchase return here. Okay. When it is purchase return account, okay? In both the cases, purchase return is credited. Anand account debtor to purchase return. Chandran account debtor to purchase return. To purchase return means it is credited. Purchase return account is credited. So come to the credit side. By Anand account 1000. By Chandran account 4500, or you can write by sundry creditors together, single entry, sundry creditors, how much? 4300. Okay, 5300, that way is also right. Okay, this is how you prepare the ledger accounts. After preparing this ledger, you may start with problem number 15. Start doing problem number 15. Prepare purchase return book. Can you see the question number 15? Sayujya, 6050. Check your answer. See, the answer is given there. check your answer please. Aparna, you're also getting the same, then that means the textbook answer is wrong. Their trade discount, did you do the trade discount part? Yes, was that considered?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes or no?
Ma'am, yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes, okay, okay. Return goods to Karthik traders, 1200, okay. Then goods return to Sahil Private Limited, 2500, okay. Goods return to Kohinoor traders for list price 2000, less 10% discount. So it becomes 1800, am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. So what is then? Return out of hand at traders. You may prepare the ledger accounts also, okay? Let me see. $1,200 plus $2,500 plus $1,800. Yes, it is 6,050. Okay. So you may correct the final answer given in the textbook. It is 6,050. Yes, it's almost time. So we will continue in the next session. Okay? Please do 15 or we'll continue in that session. No problem. See you all. Thank you so much. Thank you. Mm-hmm.